slipping lower for the market, actually. The mid-cap index now down by about 1%, currently at the low point of the day with a cut of almost 200 points. We have the Nifty Bank too lower by about 100 points. What's taking the mid-cap index lower? Well, just in the last 5-odd minutes, we've had the pharmaceutical stocks taking that back lower. The top F&O loser in the mid-cap space, of course, is Wockhardt, down 8% now, losing the battle for the prostate cancer drug Zytiga, which is worth about $1.8 billion. That stock taking an exaggerated knock down about 7.5% out there. What's also not doing well are the other pharmaceutical stocks. We have Glenmark Pharma at the low point of the day, Strides at the low point of the day. We have Aurobindo too, which is at the low point of the day. Technology stocks also not doing too well. Remember, the dollar index was at 97.5, but we are seeing some strength on the rupee, so which is not aiding the cause of technology stocks. So we have something like NIIT Tech or Just Dial, KPIT Tech, all the mid-cap IT stocks too at the low point of the day. Also, we have Godfrey Phillips, which has suddenly taken a sharp knock towards the lower end of today's trading session. Majority of the cuts have come by just in the last 15 odd minutes. For the Nifty too, we're down by about 10 points. The Sensex lower by about 50 points. For the Nifty, importantly, a couple of the big heavyweights are trying to bat for it. L&T, that one should come up for you. That one's up by about 0.5% as we speak. Trying to bat for the bulls, but nothing's coming undone right now. It is down 10 points nevertheless. But PTC India, that stock is on our radar on the back of their second quarter results, which can be read as a good set despite relatively weak second quarter earnings as their asset quality has improved. To discuss this and more, we have Pawan Singh, the MD and the CEO of the company, who joins us on the show. Thanks a lot, Mr. Singh, for joining in your perhaps your first quarter as the new MD and CEO. If you could tell us, you know, what caused this improvement in asset quality? What was the sort of recovery that you saw in this quarter with regards to bad assets?
Thank you very much. In fact, our focus now is on reduction of the stress assets, and that is what has been reflected in the improvement in the asset quality. But of course, also in the result, there are stress assets which don't form part of the gross NPA and net NPA, which normally is reflected in the results. And here I would like to say that we have been able to resolve out of total stress asset of 1700 crores which we had in our book. We have been able to resolve close to about 850 crore worth of asset, which is including the close of this quarter which went by, and beginning of this quarter. The various strategies have been adopted. I mean, we have one-time resolution plan, that which we have very aggressively and actively followed. Okay. We have also followed the other routes through, you know, one or two cases through ARC, which has also fructified.
All right. Okay, Mr. Singh. So you're telling us that, in fact, you know, quite a large part of the stressed assets were resolved in the past quarter. What's the trajectory going ahead? Do you expect to resolve more amount of these stressed assets? And also give us some clarity in terms of the NIMs. It's come in very marginally lower on a sequential basis, but cost of funds are going up, isn't it? Will it pressurize your NIMs going ahead?
NIMs, of course, are also a factor of the equity consumption which happens. The ideal way to look at it is the spread. Yeah. And if you look at the spread, of course, compared to the previous quarter of the last year, there has been a reduction in the spread. But if I compare it with the previous quarter of the current year, there has been a marginal improvement. So most of our lending is on the floating rate basis. So whatever cost increase has come, which would, because eventually last quarter we have seen that even in the current quarter there has been some tightening of the liquidity, and because of that the cost of borrowings has marginally increased, but then that will get covered in the our assets, which are mostly priced on a floating rate basis.
Right. Mr. Singh, if you could, you know, throw some light on the repayments that took place. What was the loan growth in this quarter, year on year? Because what we see is quarter on quarter, loan growth has come by and then disbursements have declined. Is that on account of lower repayments?
No, compared to the previous quarter, last time, there has been a marginal increase. And the corresponding quarter, of course, there has been a small reduction. But loan disbursement probably is also a factor of the liquidity pressure which was there in the last month of the previous quarter, which is, of course, now as going forward easing out. Mm-hmm. So we would have a normal disbursement and normal growth in the current year.
What was the loan growth on the Y&Y basis?
Loan growth has been on year-to-year basis, of course, compared to the Q2 of which was 10,512 crores, Q2 of 19 stands at 13,336 crores, so which is close to about 27%.
In percentage terms, sir, what is that, if you could help?
There is 27%.
27%, okay.
All right. It is 27% growth.
All right.
Mr. Singh, if you could tell us.
And this is the kind of growth we will maintain to.
Right.
So yeah, this is the kind of growth we will be maintaining around the year.
All right, fair point there. Mr. Singh, if you could tell us a little about your borrowing mix, you know, how much of your high cost debt is coming up for repayment or low cost debt is coming up for repayment for you to, you know, refinance that? Could there be an impact on your margins on account of that?
See, it is not necessarily because of the repayment, because many of our long-term loans also get repriced because on their benchmark to a reference rate. Hmm. So they would get repriced at an annual basis. As I said, that the repricing, because our borrowings to a large extent would be, you know, floating. Hmm. And similarly, our lending also is to a large extent on floating base. So whatever is repricing which would happen, because that would be market reflective or cost reflective, which will get captured in our assets, which we would reprice accordingly, because we now are, what we are doing is that we are repricing our asset. Earlier we were doing it with the frequency of a quarter, but we have started doing it much more closely as the market moves.
Mr. Singh, before we let you go, you know, you said that there is 1700 crore worth stressed assets in your book, of which 850 crores have been resolved by you. So just another question, is there a chance that this 1700 crore would balloon a little more going forward? Are you seeing some stress? And by the end of this year, do you expect to be completely stress-free as far as this book is concerned?
Coming to your first question, these most of stress assets have arisen out of thermal projects. And thermal assets, we are scaling it down. At one time, about 2 years back, it used to be close to 30% of our asset. Today, it stands at 17%. With resolution of 700 crore worth of thermal assets, which is going to come down to about less than 10% of our book size. So, and as far as our renewable asset goes, which is a very, very large portion of our asset, and the other portion, which constitutes the second largest component of our assets, the pressure is almost not there. There is no NPA, or there is not even SMA2 kind of a reporting happening there. So we can say that, yes, the trend is that probably by end of this year, a large portion of our stress assets would have been resolved. And further slippages, we are not expecting.
Okay. All right. Thanks so much, Mr. Singh, for joining in and giving us all those details. But let's shift focus now to Wokart. Ekta joins us in the studio, and we have Mr. Korakiwala as well, who joins us. Ekta, take it over.
Thanks, Nigel, for that. Mr. Korakiwala of Wokart is with us to basically discuss this particular drug called Zytiga generic, where a couple of companies, including Amneal and Dr. Reddy's, have lost an appeal to launch the drug. To talk more about it, we have Mr. Korakiwala with us. Mr. Korakiwala, if you can just take us through what exactly happened in the U.S. court. There's a temporary injunction to launch this particular drug, Zytiga, in the U.S.?
Yes, you know, we had won the case in the lower court, and there was an emergency, it was an appeal in the higher court. So the judge has granted emergency stay motion against the earlier order, which had allowed us to market generic. And the hearing will begin soon, and we may have the outcome of within 2 weeks. Because fundamentally, the patent case which we have is a very strong case, and we believe, the industry believes, that we will get a favorable decision when the hearing takes place.
Okay. So when is this hearing expected now, Mr. Korakiwala?
It will start in next few days, but we expect the outcome to come within the next 2 weeks.
Okay. So the final outcome will be in the next 2 weeks. But yes. Currently, what is the status of your approval on this particular drug? It's a tentative approval.
Yeah, it is a tentative approval, and we expect any time to receive the final approval.
Okay. What about the other companies, sir? Because is the opportunity diluted? Because I understand the others, such as Amneal, Dr. Reddy's, etc., also have approval, either tentative or final?
Yeah, there will be a few more companies in the race. But we believe that collectively still the opportunity would be significant for Wokat.
Okay, so what would you quantify the opportunity to be? It's $1.8 billion in terms of a market size, and correct me if I'm wrong. So what would it probably be diluted to for Wokat in terms of, say, would it still remain a limited competition?
It's very difficult to say because another 2 weeks is there. And it will be significant, but I am not able to put a number to it at this point in time because there are a lot of uncertainties around it.
Okay. This will be via a third-party manufacturer, I'm guessing.
Sorry?
This will be via a third-party manufacturer?
By a third-party manufacturer, yes.
Okay. Just on that particular point, sir, your U.S. business was significantly higher this quarter, up around 18-odd%, if I'm not mistaken. All of it was led by third-party manufacturers.
That is correct.
So what is that the strategy that you're adopting now going forward?
No, we had adopted this strategy some time back, and as we are getting product approved, our U.S. sales will show buoyancy in the months and quarters to come.
So what would happen in terms of the remediation and maybe a U.S. FDA re-inspection of the plants?
We expect that we will offer a plan for remediation by end of the month, end of the year. And we hope that the inspection would take place early next year.
Okay. And WCK 5222, can you give us an update on where things stand, especially with regards to your Dubai facility?
The WCK 5222 is at the end of phase 3 clinical trial. And we expect the clinical trial to be completed and filing to be done by sometime in 2020.
Okay. Any out-licensing opportunity on that one?
We have nothing to report on that.
Okay. All right, Mr. Karakiwala, we leave it on that note. Thanks very much for joining in talking to us. So that is the management of Wokat clarifying that, yes, Zytiga has received a temporary injunction in the U.S. markets as of now, but that there will be a hearing in the next 2 weeks, and maybe that it will still continue to be an opportunity for a company such as Wokat, considering the size of the drug is $1.8 billion.
Absolutely. Thanks a lot for that, Ekta. Some important clarification coming in from the management, and that's put a near-term floor to the stock as of right now we speak.